Hi, we're coming to you live from Glenwood Canyon. We're at mile marker 123.5, Blue Gulch. This is where the damage is the worst. In many ways, this is really the reason why Highway 70 to Glenwood Canyon is still closed. There literally is no road on the eastbound, and significant damage on the westbound for a short period where it was effectively destroyed. That has to be patched up before traffic can flow. After meeting with CDOT engineers and really pushing to get this open as quickly as they can, and of course it has to be safe, I'm confident that it'll be open Saturday afternoon with one lane each way. Keep in mind, through much of the canyon, it'll be two lanes, normal traffic. It's only about a three-quarter mile patch where it'll have to go down to one lane. And that's because there's been degradation of the road, of the structure, on both sides, so they're going to only allow travel on the lane that is safe as they work to repair those additional lanes. I'd point out that even though Glenwood Canyon will be open Saturday afternoon, there will likely be additional short-term closures in the weeks ahead. They will try to schedule those during the least traffic times, and they will be short, many of them 20, 30 minutes, as they do the necessary improvements to supply the power redundancy to Hanging Lake Tunnel is one example, and other necessary repairs. A lot of this area that we're at and just ahead was buried under 10 to 15 feet of mud just as short as a week ago. And frankly, CDOT engineers didn't know what would happen when they dug to the bottom. Fortunately, in the other areas covered with mud, there was no structural damage to the road. Here at mile marker 123.5, there was just damage to a very limited area, and those repairs will be complete enough to allow for one lane each way by Saturday afternoon. And that is one lane on both the eastbound and the westbound. So it's not that there's one open with both lanes next to each other in a dangerous way. Each of them, but eastbound and the westbound, the upper and the lower deck, will be open for one lane of traffic for this three-quarter mile stretch by Saturday afternoon. The rest of Glenwood Canyon, we'll have the ordinary two lanes, again, subject to limited additional closures over the next few weeks for final repairs. So I think I want to thank the Colorado Department of Transportation engineers, workers. They've worked tirelessly. We're joined by Executive Director Shoshana Liu, just tirelessly to haul tons and tons of mud out of here, doing the emergency repairs that they needed to get this open. We really recognize the importance of this corridor for Colorado, for Coloradans, for Glenwood Springs residents, but also for the entire country in terms of an important freight corridor for trucks. And that's an additional reason why we put the federal emergency declaration in. The federal government's already released $11 million, about 10% of the total request. That's enough to get a lot of these emergency repairs. We also have a medium-term and long-term plan to reduce the likelihood of future foreclosures. I also want to point out, we are at this point still extremely susceptible to additional rainfall and flooding. So everything on the timeline that we announced is subject to it continuing to be dry and safe conditions. We had an unprecedented amount of rain in late July, about a month worth of rain in about a 6 or 7 day period that led to the enormous amounts of mudslide that we see here today. So as long as we have dry weather, we should be able to open Saturday afternoon with a lane each way for about a three-quarter mile stretch, two lanes for the rest of it. Full functions back by Thanksgiving, with a goal by the end of October to have the full two lanes functioning uninterrupted throughout Glenwood Canyon.